on the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium, just north of downtown Tampa. Certainly happy to have you along. Chase McLaughlin has it on the tee, and off we go here in Tampa. Breaks through the contact, and a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. San Francisco set to go on offense once more. So first and 10 now from the 30. This is Samuel. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. And you've probably talked about since training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Better ball security, but not much else to show for it.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Though certainly not the start they were looking for here as they come up on a third and 14. Throwing here, Purdy. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Mason. And he'll only get this to about the 35. Well short of the line to gain. It's a gain of 9, but it's also going to mean a punt here on their opening drive.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. And this is a beauty as that ball is going to angle out at the 6-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. Mayfield on first down. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
Well, they were backed up to start the drive, but how about that aggressiveness? Firing it downfield right away. Nice job there getting out towards what would have been their normal starting position.
A first down throw for Mayfield. Completes this again to Shepard. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
So we just called his name on the previous snap, and they go right back to him, Charles, for a second consecutive completion.
Yeah, I think what we're discovering on this drive is that he feels like he has answers no matter what defense you throw up there. He reads it, finds the open spot, and is available for the completion.
They will run for the first time here with White, and tackled down after a gain of 3, leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, and defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
Third down and 1. To throw, Mayfield. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? Force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that.
Yeah,
moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, do I have that dagger play? Do I have that play and just finish them off right now? Because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
That's a very nice game there, a confidence-building run. Love the execution up front, and the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
So they go from one 42-yard line to the other as they come up now first and 10. They stay on the ground with White.
tackle by Jordan Elliott.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Here's 2nd and 5 now from the 37. They defer to White out of the shotgun. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
They do not score, fellas. They do not score.
This will be the 8th play of the drive here. 3rd and 4. Now Mayfield. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. That good for 6 as they keep this drive right on rolling. Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with 6 and not 3.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want to throw body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping in one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
We're scoreless after 1. 2nd quarter now in Tampa Bay. It's the Buccaneers in control of the football. This 2nd and 4. As they've got it as we resume action. Mayfield looks to throw. He's got Otten. And they just keep marching right along. 1st down on a pickup of 8 there. Mayfield finding Otten once more. So apparently some grabbing there in the middle of the O-line.
I've often wondered why that doesn't happen more often for guys that play center. Having to snap the ball and then trying to get your hands into the proper position, that's difficult to do. He got caught that time.
They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Mayfield now. Buying time to his left. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
They go play action. Mayfield. That's completed right side to Palmer. And the Bucs are going to have a 1st and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
Boy, this is a well-orchestrated drive they've put together. You think back to how far they were backed up to start things out, but they've gone on a march since then. And now after that completion there, they've got a 1st and goal.
Let's get it together, defense. Let's get it together. Bring some time.
White, and he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up 2nd and goal.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
They give it off here to the tight end. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Co-Keeft. A touchdown run there from 1 yard out. And the Bucs go nearly the length of the field and finish it off with 6 points. And that run caps off a 99-yard drive.
Would it be safe to say that finishing run is an exclamation point on this one.
Big time. Well, I mean, 99-yard drive.
I mean, when you start that, all you're thinking about as an offense is somehow trying to create room for your punter. And if you can get two first downs, you've considered the drive a success. I don't know what you call this, all the way down, putting in the end zone. That's pretty spectacular.
Ultimate success. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Now couldn't take the chance. This will be returned from the goal line. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their second drive. As we eke closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like, because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge, because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets them to second and 4.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here, and what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here now, 2nd and 4. Back to throw, Purdy. High throw, but he makes the catch. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 27 yards there, a first down.
Love when the playbook comes to life and the execution is there. Man coverage on the outside. And if you like the matchup and you feel like your receiver can get the position he needs, you just throw it up there and let him do his thing. We see this a lot now with back shoulder routes and things like that. And this is a nice job to go up and get it. And they pick up a first down.
And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5.
And I think he just wanted to give the ball to one of his playmakers to see if they can make something happen, but he ends up throwing into a crowded area. And after the catch, he isn't able to do much with it.
Throwing on 2nd down, it's Purdy. That's into the hands of the rookie from Florida. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a 1st down.
Hey, been there, done that. Got you, ready?
Again, it's Purdy to throw it. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the 1st tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Here's Purdy. This pass to Jennings, and he makes the catch. And the Niners are going to have a 1st and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. Purdy now to throw. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
That's a really nice job there by the coverage, understanding that they're in a high-stakes situation. If he doesn't make a play on that ball, there's an excellent chance it ends up either as a touchdown or as a nice gain downfield.
They'll Try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal. Purdy. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodged 2 pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on 3rd and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
Purdy sets up to throw again. And now another one thrown incomplete.
Great defense there on 3rd and goal. They took away everything. Forced him to fire that one to the sideline where no one could get it.
So Purdy off and Moody on for the 49er field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And his kick here is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Well, still trailing here, but they do get the late field goal. Now their defense will try to keep this score right where it is heading into the locker room.
Yeah, and trailing at the break, you obviously don't want to go in off of a negative play. Give them credit for that one. Finding a way to put points on the board. Give them any type of a spark, anything to build off of as they try and plan a comeback.
So after the made field goal by Moody, he's back out to kick this one away. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Well, the Bucs going to take over now late in this first half. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
First down, Mayfield. Throw left side, taken in by Palmer. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Here's Mayfield. That's again complete to Palmer. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Mayfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
2nd and 10. Mayfield to throw it. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Malik Collins able to drop him for a loss of a couple. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. So 2 quarters down, 2 remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
Taken at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter.
Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. Now Mayfield and the Bucs come up on first and 10
at their own 26.
They'll start here with a handoff to White.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
Fred Warner, the all-pro linebacker, there on the stop.
The 4-3 defense there did its job, funneled things right to the middle linebacker.
If they do a nice job of playing team defense, everyone takes care of their responsibilities. That allows that guy in the middle to do his job, which is search and destroy.
On second down, they'll run with White. 5 yards, now it's third and five.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Here is third and five.
From the gun, Mayfield.
He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it. And that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, for a quick punting situation.
Here comes the Buccaneers punter now as he's on to kick it away. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half.
And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal.
His struggles finding open receivers continue. I don't know the last time I saw him this inconsistent throwing the football.
It would be hard to find a date when he was this inconsistent. You know, in his locker, he keeps the word poise printed on an 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. He needs to find that poise right now.
He certainly does. In fact, I would suggest he laminate it.
And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of five.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down, because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Purdy looking to throw.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. A big third down play there for the Niners. And even 50 yards.
That's the kind of play this offense desperately needed. They've got to be saying, our defense has kept us in the ballgame. We're down, but we're certainly not out. And maybe that was the spark that they've been searching for.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
6 yards there on the keeper. It's second down.
Now that's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained. And, in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
Purdy will set up to throw it here.
That's going to be caught by Samuel. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
First catch of the game there for Samuel, and it results in a first down. Now Purdy.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. fortunate to get that football back, because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
Very fortunate to get another shot. Here's second and goal. Now he's forced out right. And he gets this inside the 10 to the 9. It's also a gain of 9.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Operating from the gun, Purdy. And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Ricky Pearsall, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Niners have taken the lead here in this third quarter. So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they've turned that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Mayfield on play action. Forced out to his left. 4 yards there as they let him out of the pocket, and he got enough for the first.
As he came to the line of scrimmage, he knew he didn't need much to reset the chain, so when he saw the space he needed, no hesitation. He went to the marker and got his guys a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He'll find McMillan here. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Tampa. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Second down, Mayfield.
There's a short one taken in by Otten.
Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. They'll drop to throw.
There's a short one taken in by Otten.
That'll go for a gain of 7. And it's second down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Here's second and three. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete. Right now, the story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion for us there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone, toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
That was for the lead right there. They know they're in a position where fortune favors the brave, so they took their shot but couldn't connect.
So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And his kick is no good. And just barely missing it wide to the right. And instead of tying it up, they'll remain down by three. A fourth quarter miss like that, there is no lonelier feeling than that kicker right now.
As we all know, a lot of these games, they come down to special teams. And when that chance comes, you have to perform in order to help your team get over the top.
Could have tied it. Instead, they remain down three. A handoff to start the drive to Mason. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. The tackle made by Zion McCollum.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
They'll run again with Mason. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line.
And this is the worry, because sometimes you can get a little too predictable in spots like this. You know you're going to run the ball, but they know you're going to run the ball as well. And now you look up and you're staring at an important third down.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Looking to throw, Purdy. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a Niners first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Now they run. It's Mason. Down to about the 37. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. They'll get it forward to him on the touch pass. And he'll take this one down to the 36. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Here's Purdy now on third and goal. He'll get this to Jennings over the middle. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now Mason. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. The Bucks going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They work now on second and nine. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. And he will have a Niners first down. And that ought to be the one that seals the victory. And they will take a knee here. This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Now Samuel. Oh, look at that. And they'll get to him just inside the 15. Even after the strong run we just saw, they're able to corral him quickly defensively. Should be the final act of the ball game.
I don't know about you, partner, but watching them take the knee there and finish this one off, I feel like I'm going to be sore tomorrow. This was one bruising affair, low scoring, but my kind of football.
Not a work of art, but maybe in your world, a little bit of a work of art. You like the defensive side.
I thought it was pretty. I can't help myself. I thought it was pretty.
And it ends in a kneel down as the clock rolls down to zeros.
Well, obviously, Charles, this was by no means an offensive track meet. I mean, the defenses were the story in this ball game, but hey, they got enough points to get the job done, and at the end of the day, that's all that matters.
You're absolutely right about that, partner. In such a low-scoring game, it completely changes everything you had planned to do out there. Fortunately for them, they got just enough scoring to bring home the win, and in this type of a game, the play of their defense, that became one of their biggest keys.